Welcome to Drawfee, where we take your dumb ideas
and make even dumber drawings.
I'm Jacob.
I'm Nathan.
And I'm Karina.
And today's episode comes to us from the Drawfee Patreon Discord user, Draconia, or Dracania.
Ooh.
And they said, creating characters based on weird plant names? Some examples, Sneezeweed, Mad Dog Skullcap, Sticky Willy, Dracula Simia, etc.
Wow, there's some weird plant names.
Every friend group has one.
Every friend group has one of each of these.
Tag yourself, I'm Sticky Willy.
If you can't figure out who the Sticky Willy is, it's you.
I wish I was Mad Dog Skullcap, but I know that's actually Karina.
Ha cha cha cha. It's okay, my little Sneezeweed.
So I've gotten together five weird plant names. I got them in a randomizer, and I'm going to roll them up for each of us to make a character out of.
Yeah.
Nathan, are you ready for yours?
Yes.
Nathan, I would like for you to draw our good friend, Humped Bladderwort.
Ew.
Come on.
That's not my friend. I hate that guy.
That's nasty.
That's our good friend. We all love Humped Bladderwort.
Humped Bladderwort.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure.
A friend to all.
Humped as in H-U-M-P-T or H-U-M-P-E-D?
E-E-D, like humped. The Humped Bladderwort.
Oh, no.
This is like a henchman.
Yeah, big henchman energy with the name.
This is sort of like,
more like a humpman.
This is a humpman. The main villain's humpman.
Yeah.
Oh, humpman.
Humped Bladderwort. He's sort of doing one of these.
One of what?
He's like doing a little crouch.
Oh, okay, yeah. I do that sometimes, where I just crouch over and go...
Just point at things.
Like a bog witch, yeah.
We've sort of caught him doing like a classic bog witch crouch. And you know what? I think this is a friend. He's nasty, and maybe we don't love his job. But when you get him outside of work, he's okay.
Yeah.
He's okay.
You can't write someone off just because they have a weird, upsetting name. They're probably just okay. I look at Benedict Cumberbatch. He's gone so far.
I like that you weren't willing to go as far as to say we like him. But we are willing to say he's okay.
Yeah.
He's all right.
He's fine. It's not the worst when he comes out with you. It's like he doesn't like make the evening or anything, but he doesn't harsh the vibe either.
Yeah.
He leaves the real upsetting energy at the office.
Which is so valid.
He's just trying to have a fun night out like anyone.
Yeah, and he needs it. And maybe he's acting kind of weird. He has a shitty job.
Yeah.
Let him live.
If you were a humpman, you would do the same.
Yeah. The evil scientist he works for is just, good benefits.
Yeah.
But it's a toxic work environment for sure.
Ain't that the way.
But it's hard to leave when you don't know, where your next paycheck's going to come from.
Exactly. This is a pose that I'm not good at drawing, but I have attempted it anyway.
I think it looks really nice.
Yeah.
I just don't know where this other leg goes. Is it cut out like this?
Oh my god.
That's nastier. I feel like you had it right the first time.
Okay.
I think it depends on how irritating you want me to be. It can go the way you had it. It's just a bit of an extreme split.
Yeah. It makes it seem more like he's really like dropping it down. Like he's at the club.
Oh, what is this?
I'm just trying some stuff out.
Yeah.
We're still in the undersketch.
The position of this back leg is going to say so much about this guy's personality.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think it's just sort of right here coming in. And we're just
this is an acceptable position
Yeah.
This kind of looks like he's maybe thinking about shitting.
Yeah.
But he's not like spread eagle, like hanging schlong in front of everyone, like that other leg position says.
He hasn't committed to the shitted.
He's not shitted. Not yet, at least.
Yeah.
But it does seem like his ass is out.
Well, no, that's just, like, I'm doing the under sketch.
Yeah. Stop being a pervert, Jacob. Maybe he's just wearing really tight pants.
I'm just commenting on what I'm seeing.
Yeah.
This is just what I'm seeing is his full ass and it's out.
Be patient.
Here we go. It's just, you know,
the ass is yet to recede.
This, and then he's got like one of these, sort of like a tunic sort of thing.
Oh.
Okay, but his ass is poking out from under the tunic.
Bare ass. Oh, okay. Covered ass. But the form isn't hidden at all.
No.
They're tight pants.
Yeah.
These are form-fitting pants.
Yeah, he's just like, I'm not going to show you the full crack, but you will know that I have a dumpy.
Yeah. Yeah. He's got his jeggings on underneath his tunic. I mean, when you got to ask like that, when you got to ask like a humpman, let it show. Let it fly.
His humps.
He's highlighting his strongest features. I think
his lovely humpman humps.
His lovely humpman humps. That's what people are here to see. He knows it. And so he's kind of like doing that thing where he's bending over to pick something up and his tunic rides up a bit and you catch a glimpse of his humpman's humps.
He's doing the bend and snap.
Yeah, he's doing the bend and snap. He's looking back at you because he knows you're looking.
Caught you staring. Take a picture, it'll last longer.
I caught you ogling me humps. Don't worry, everybody does.
What was his last name?
It was Hump.
We're really hump, focusing on the Hump.
It was Hump. But it's something wart.
Yeah.
I already lost it.
Giggle wart, squiggle wart.
Oh my God.
No, it was nastier than that.
Puss wart, wart puss.
It was something. I'm going to get it back. Give me a second.
It was bladder wart, right?
Yeah, because he has a bladder. Bladder
wart. Yes. Humped bladder wart. That is correct. Do you want to know about the flower that it is?
Yeah.
This aquatic carnivorous plant can be found almost anywhere water is present, from the United States and Canada to Africa and Asia. Grown primarily in lakes and canals, this flower is about as gruesome as its name implies. To get its nutrients, a humped bladderwort captures small prey in its bladder and digests it over time.
A flower has a bladder?
This flower does.
Oh my God. For piss?
It seems more like a capture bladder.
Oh.
To get little fishies in there and then slowly dissolve them.
Imagine if people had capture bladders.
You just kind of open it up and see what falls in there. It's a very passive way.
It's like Street Pass, or what was that on the Nintendo DS, whatever.
Yeah, Street Pass.
Yeah, but with your bladder.
But with your bladder. Yeah. Yeah. And see what you get. I think it's nice.
I think it'd be cool.
I mean, you're telling me that if you could just, like, instead of having to cook food or, like, go out and find food, you could just like sort of open up your bladder and then just like go about your day and you get what you need in there. That would save you so much time.
I'd try it.
Yeah, I'd give it a shot.
I'd try anything once.
You'd be foolish not to.
Yeah, why not?
And then plants can photosynthesize too. Imagine if we could do that. I want to photosynthesize.
Yeah.
Episodes like this are why people bully us.
Who bullies us?
You know who you are.
We're unbullyable.
Yeah.
Because we have no shame.
Aw, you're going to bully me? Careful. I'm going to catch you in my bladder.
And slowly digest you. you thought you were bullying me, but what's that? Look around you. You're in my bladder. While you were trying to bully me, I captured you.
Oh, you came a little too close in your efforts to bully me. Now you're stuck.
Now you've become food. Who's getting bullied now?
You know what? I take it back. I love this idea.
Yeah. It's anti-bullying measures.
They should start calling that, using that as the term for like self-defense, like biological things in animals. like what is it? The horned toad that squirts blood out of its eyes. That's my anti-bullying measure.
Yeah. Another animal was trying to bully the toad. And we're not standing for it anymore.
Yeah. Man, I wish I could do that.
Yeah, we don't have any cool like things we can do against bullies. I mean, we can like try to fight them like with our hands and feet and stuff, but I'd rather just be able to like squirt something.
Yeah, I would love to squirt blood out of, I don't know, somewhere convenient.
Yeah. Just one squirt.
Yeah, be a little biohazard. But no, I can't do that. So instead I had to develop an extremely toxic personality.
I want to be able to like spray out like a mist, like a foul mist.
Like a skunk.
Yeah. And they're so upset and distracted by the mist that I can get away. And yeah, just like a skunk, it like gets on your clothes and you have to throw them out. You can never get it off. Where's that stuff?
Yeah, I want that.
I guess we just use like tools for that instead.
I guess.
Like pepper spray.
I'm just like, sometimes I look at a skunk and I go, I want what she has.
Yeah, they seem so confident.
Skunk's got it all.
They're like cool looking. They got highlights.
Yeah.
And they can emit a foul mist.
I try so hard to do all those things, but it's just too difficult. It doesn't come as naturally to me.
No.
It's not fair. Life's not fair.
When I get highlights and emit a foul mist, everyone hates it.
Do we see this guy's other hand, or is this it?
It depends what he's doing with that hand. What that hand do, Nathan?
Yeah, what the hand do?
What could he be doing with his other hand?
Capturing something in his bladder for food.
Yeah, he could be having like a fish and he's about to stuff it in his bladder.
Shoving it right up his bladder.
Okay.
Maybe he's like reaching back like around, you know.
I'm gonna stop myself before I say anything worse. Take a sip of my drink.
Yeah, cool off, Karina.
Ugh. Ugh.
Got too hot and bothered. It kind of looks like he's picking food off the floor at the bar. Yeah.
For later. Yeah, this is the guy, like, you go down to grab your coat from, like, under the bar, and this guy's rooting around down there.
He's got a whole fish.
Wow.
Someone dropped a whole fish. And he's like, a special treat for me today.
Yeah. Just pick a bar in the Lower East Side on a weekend. We've all been there. Yeah.
This one will take my bladder a full week to digest.
Yeah.
Everyone else at the bar is just like, okay.
We're just trying to enjoy our night out. And he's like, no, no. You need to understand.
You need to listen to my biology working. Turn the music down, DJ. I have a fish to digest.
Give me the microphone.
I'll digest it too.
Then everyone can hear what I do. It's like, man, we're in New York City. It's fine for you to do whatever you want. Just let us have our beer.
Yeah.
Like, we don't care what you're doing with your bladder.
This is why I don't go out.
I think this is it.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is good.
This is a really good character design.
Yeah, I think this is Humpty Bladderwort. What was his name?
Humped Bladderwort.
Humpty Bladderwort.
Yeah. Yeah. Humped.
Friends call him Humpty.
Yeah.
It's a cute little nickname.
If he had friends.
Yeah, this is great. You can tell because it really brought out something disgusting in Jacob and I.
Yeah.
This is how we're trying to be.
We're starting off nasty, but you know, not all plants are nasty.
No, maybe the next one that I'll draw won't be nasty.
And you know what's something not nasty that you can do? You watching this video.
Oh, what's that?
What?
The least nasty thing you could do is hit that subscribe button.
Yeah, if you hit it quickly enough, we'll stop saying horrible, disgusting, bladder-related scenarios in this episode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We can feel it when you subscribe.
Yeah. Ooh. Ooh.
Just in case we keep saying nasty stuff in this episode, sorry you didn't hit it fast enough this time.
That's on you.
But, you know, you'll get it next time for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next episode, subscribe again, and maybe you can.
Yeah.
Drawfee quick time events.
Yeah, hit the bell.
Yeah, hit the bell to prevent bladder talk. Ooh, you missed.
You missed.
Oh, sorry. Better luck next time. You gotta watch every video and keep doing it. Eventually it'll work.
Well, what if I draw now?
I would love that.
You should.
I'm gonna find out what it is that I'm gonna draw.
Okay.
And I'll tell you right now, it's another friend.
Oh?
This one goes by the name of Corncockle.
Corncockle! Oh my god!
Corncockle is here. Who's that who just walked into the bar?
Oh.
It's Corncockle.
Oh, it's Corncockle.
I can't wait to find out what you think a cockle is.
Well, a cockle, isn't it like some sort of like barnacle?
It's like a little clam.
Oh, I thought it was an RPF pairing.
What does that mean?
Don't worry about it.
People will know.
If you understood the joke Karina just made, leave a comment.
Show yourself, you nasty, nasty bitches.
Comment on this video with "I understood Karina's cockle joke."
So I'm not going to go the direction of like a barnacle. I just kind of want a nasty little corn freak.
It's like a clam. It's like a little clam.
Oh, it's like a clam.
Yeah, I've had a cockle pasta. Sort of like linguine and clams.
You cockle pasta.
You cockle pasta.
Come on.
Cockle pasta. It's like a copy pasta.
You've heard of creepy pasta, but what about cockle pasta?
I'm gonna have to really struggle.
Jacob.
I'm trying not to.
Jacob.
I'm trying not to.
Ew!
But Jacob, this shape.
Well, I wanted it to be.
This is the nastiest episode. Julia isn't even here.
I gotta get rid of this. I gotta get rid of this shape.
Trying the nastiest. No, I appreciate it though, because I was worried that my guy was too nasty. And in a few lines, Jacob, you've already managed to draw something so nasty that you had to start over again.
It's a cockle, not another thing. You drawing some cockle pasta, son?
I'm just drawing some cockle pasta.
With some corn?
Okay, maybe I will go like the direction of like a clam.
Yeah.
To avoid other shapes?
I mean, there's only so much avoiding we can do. But I think this will be better.
For sure.
For sure.
It's just sort of like...
He just can't help himself.
It's just so... There's only so much I can do.
It's like a little...
You just can't...
Hatches?
What?
The ridges! The rumble. bagel strips. No.
Listen, the sooner I can make this into corn, the better it's going to be.
I feel like there's more. You know what? You're right. Yeah. I'm the one who should be apologizing for thinking it looks like some sort of freaky butt plug.
A little context for the recording. It's a very hot, muggy day in New York today.
It sure is.
And we turn off all of our fans and air conditioners when we record so that the sound is delicious, crisp. Mm-hmm. So I'm just sort of here stewing in just sort of this sauna that I've made for myself and watching this shape come into existence.
What Nathan's trying to say is that we're all getting a little too hot and bothered by this.
Yeah, it's just a nasty time. It's a nasty time for my body. It's a nasty time for my mind. It's a nasty time for my soul.
We're going to talk around the fact that this looks like a weird butt plug dildo, but like...
Yeah.
Okay, so it's coming out of the clam.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's corn cockle.
The corn is coming out of the cockle.
Yeah.
Jacob's gone sort of one-to-one with this.
Well, I'm saying, imagine you're at the bar.
Yeah.
And you're looking...
And this guy slaps your girl's ass.
Yeah, what do you do? No, he doesn't slap your girl's ass. You're looking down.
Yeah, he slides up yours.
You're looking down because the horned wart meddler is down there eating your fish.
Humpty bladder wart.
The humpty bladder wart is down there eating your fish, and then the saloon doors swing open. You look up, and in walks a cockle.
Yeah.
And you're like, what's going on now? And then the cockle opens, and you're like, oh, it's corn cockle. Oh, thank God.
Yeah, you immediately know what it is once it opens, and you're like, ah, yeah, it's corn.
Well, everyone in the bar is like, hey, corn cockle. I was worried it was just cockle.
Everyone loves corn cockle.
Once we give him a little face, I think that's going to help.
The face is going to really bring this home.
Oh, beautiful little eyes. Yeah. There he is.
Aww.
Yeah. Aww, buddy.
Okay. I like him better now.
See, it's pretty good, actually.
Hey, corn cockle. What's up? The usual?
Oh, hey.
What's up?
Just the normal stuff.
What's the little doodads at the bottom? Are those the legs?
Yeah, those are going to be the legs, of
course.
Aww.
I hope they're strong.
Yeah, those are going to be his strong legs.
They have a strong start. That's the only reason I say that.
Nice and tapered. Ooh.
Yeah, I think we'll get like a really juicy calf muscle.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Shit. In there.
For sure.
And some big thighs.
Absolutely.
Because the cockle's heavy.
Right. The shell is quite heavy.
Yeah. And then when it's open, you know, it kind of throws the weight off because it's all in the back.
So the calves have to activate to keep him upright.
Yes. Yes, for sure.
And he comes in and he's just like, hey, would you mind pouring some beer inside my cockle? Because he doesn't have arms.
Michelle, I don't have arms, just really strong legs.
How's he going to get into his mouth?
That's not where it goes.
Oh, that was a silly question. You're right.
He talks with his mouth, but he doesn't drink. The beer just gets absorbed into the cockle.
Yeah. The little crevices in between the corn kernels. They slide into there, like, I get it now.
Yeah, it makes a noise.
Yeah.
And then you can see, like, from the
like
base.
An aquarium filter.
From the base up, you see the kernels getting, like, plumper.
Oh, yeah.
As they absorb. Yeah, we'll put in some, like, liquid in here.
The beer is full of nutrients that I enjoy. I don't drink to get drunk. I drink to sustain my cockle.
And everyone at the bar is like, yeah, you do, corn cockle. We love you.
We love you so much.
And then everyone claps.
Corn cockle saved my marriage. You just gave really good advice.
Yeah, Corncockle has good advice.
Yeah.
Corncockle is very emotionally intelligent, very sensitive, a great listener. You just have to sort of get past. And again, that's sort of, I think, the theme of today's episode is you know, don't judge a book by its cover.
Don't judge a corn by its cockle.
Don't judge a corn by its cockle.
Yeah.
I'm going to look up what the real corn cockle, not cockles, corn cockle.
Yeah, let's do a little bit of botany learning. We learned a little bit about humped bladderwort. We can also learn about the corn cockle.
It's a pretty flower. I'm just looking at images. I can't read. What a lovely flower.
Oh, it's saloon style doors. Very good.
Yeah, so that's how you know he's entered, because the doors like slam open because he can't really control.
They do a big swing. Well, that's why they installed these doors, was
so that Corncockle could get in.
Yeah, yeah. They had trouble before. But yeah, it's just an annual flowering plant. It's about a meter tall and covered with fine hairs.
Damn.
Ooh, fine hairs.
Just like me. I'm a meter tall and covered in fine hairs.
It's true.
Wow, this is a drawing of Jacob. This is what Jacob looks like.
He even has the hat.
Yeah.
Jacob's famous hat.
My famous hat everyone knows me for.
Yeah.
Here, let's get some fine hairs on him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Those are some fine hairs.
It helps the overall appearance of him, I think.
Yeah, absolutely.
To look less discouraging.
Yeah.
All right, I'm done.
Oh, he's... Yeah.
He's
here.
He's here.
Here he is.
You know, you can talk the tackle, but can you corn the cockle?
That's what people are always asking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you know what he says? Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can do
sure.
both.
I can do it all. I hope couples therapy's going well for you.
Oh, thanks, Corncockle, for the recommendation. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, you saved our marriage, Corncockle.
Again.
Always.
Let's have Karina draw something so we don't have to look at Corncockle anymore.
Yes, please.
He kind of grew on me.
Yeah.
The grower.
Oh, Karina,
yes,
I would like for you to draw to finish us out here.
Mm-hmm.
Can you please draw cow-vetch?
Cow-vetch.
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 Yeah, cow-vetch.
Oh my god.
Is that cow-vetch?
Stop trying to make cow-vetch happen.
Cow-vetch is not going to happen. Cow-vetch.
It's really fun to say. Try it
at
home.
Yeah.
You got to say it like that, like we're saying it, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here, go ahead. We'll wait.
Yeah.
That was fun, right?
That was good. You said it nicely.
Okay. Cow-vetch. We're just going to see where this takes Karina.
Yeah, ooh. Follow your heart. Follow cow-vetch.
Yeah. Just the sound and energy of cow-vetch.
Cow-vetch.
I know her.
Sounds like a designer.
Yeah.
I'll tell you a little bit about the plant here.
Please.
At nearly 4 feet tall, this fast-growing perennial may be a weed, but its lovely purple flowers may make you think twice about grabbing the weed killer.
Oh.
She's one of those people.
A weed that's hot, so you keep it.
Yeah, so she's toxic, but she's really attractive.
Yeah, she's hot.
Oh my god, she's just like me for real. I'm just drawing a cow.
That's cow vetch.
That's cow vetch, yeah.
She's a cow. You got a problem with that? Go write your senator. I don't care. Every day I'm trying to be cow vetch.
The type of glasses you've given this cow is giving me sort of Gary Larson vibes.
Mm-hmm.
and I don't hate it.
I don't know who that is.
That's the Far Side guy.
That's the Far Side.
Oh, I was going for like Juno Birch vibes.
Oh, okay.
Who's that?
She's a drag queen.
Oh, nice. A drag queen.
This is Juno Birch meets Gary Larson.
Oh, yeah. I definitely see what you mean here.
Yeah.
She's blue.
Yeah.
Dabba-dee-dabba-dye.
Dabba-dee-dabba-dye.
Blue No Birch.
But this isn't Juno Birch. This is no. Cowbatch.
Yeah. Cowbatch.
It's just going to turn into Cowbatch.
Y'all getting a little thunder?
I'm hearing something outside.
I'm getting a little thunder in my neck of the woods.
That's not thunder, Nathan. That's Cowbatch.
Oh, yeah. Oh, she's coming.
She's coming.
She's coming.
That's her thighs. Clapping down the street.
Yeah, she's so hot.
Yeah. Everybody comes to their window and waves their handkerchiefs as she passes.
And they cry. They cry because she ignores them.
But it's what they want. They want to be ignored by Cowbatch. But then at the end of the night at the bar, guess who it is that Cowbatch confides in? It's Corncockle.
It's Corncockle.
Yeah. The only one that Cowbatch talks to about what's really going on.
Yeah.
Oh, this looks so comfy, cozy.
You gotta.
I love a big poofy outfit.
You have to obscure your entire form to become as mysterious as Cowbatch is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Except for your thunderous thighs, because they're hot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can physically obscure them because sonically, they're unobscurable.
Yes. They cannot be hidden from my ears.
Cows have udders.
But does Cowbatch?
But does Cowbatch?
Yeah. Got a problem with udders?
No, I was just asking you.
Does it intimidate you that she's not afraid to let her udders hang out?
I mean, the confidence with which Cowbatch does everything intimidates me.
That is
true.
So,
let's give her some little cow legs.
This is such a powerful image that you're making, Karina.
This is going to inspire people in some way. I don't know what way yet. That remains to be seen when the people see it. But this is going to change someone's life. They're going to see it and they're going to be like, I'm changing everything.
Good.
Yeah.
I'm going to embody this spirit.
I'm going to channel Cowbatch.
I'm going to channel Cowbatch.
Feeling big coat.
Yeah.
Let me channel all of the extra fashion that I have seen and enjoy. Y'all are going to have to vamp for me, boys. I'm consumed with lust for Cowbatch.
I mean, here's the thing, is so are we.
Yeah.
It's like,
please, please.
It's like I'm trying to think of something to talk about.
We can't
but my
all
mind
be
is...
having quiet, lustful thoughts about Cowbatch. We're in the middle of a recording.
I know. We have to do our jobs. We have to say some funny commentary, but what if we just all sat silently
and just like human hands
contemplated Cowbatch?
We all sit in like a very uncomfortable silence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like you just hear
you can hear us quivering.
Oh, Cowbatch.
Gonna have some big sleeves. Just
oh yeah,
biggest sleeves. Match the collar, of course.
When Cowbatch goes down the street, people just throw money at her.
And she steps on it.
Yeah. That's the only job she has is... The money just gets caught up in her coat, and that's the money she makes.
Oh, she needs hair.
And she's a billionaire.
Yeah. That's how much money gets thrown at her every day, even though she never picks any of it up. She's still a billionaire.
That's just what lands on and in the coat. But she also, unlike other billionaires, she gives a lot of her money to charity because a lot of it falls out.
Yeah.
while she's walking past the charities.
Yeah.
She chooses a route that
has the most charities. Front of
the most, yeah, she's done her research and she only walks past charities.
And then when she gets home, whatever money falls out, she has a little guy who scrambles around and picks up the money and puts it in her bank.
Wait, that's my little money guy.
Is that Humpty? Is that?
Oh my God.
Is Humpty Cowvetch's little guy?
Because he hates his job or something, right?
Well, maybe he's a gig worker and that's his only good gig. Yeah.
And her titties are out. Oh, I'm sorry. Her titties are out.
Titties.
Like Monday through Thursday, he's in the lab helping like Dr. Shithead do his do his experiments. But then on the weekends, he's the little guy for Cowvetch.
Yeah, Cowvetch's little guy. Well, during the whole week, Cowvetch sleeps. And then on the weekend, that's when she comes out.
To store up her power.
Yeah. To maintain the level of beauty and poise and confidence, you need so much rest.
Yes.
Because it's incredibly draining.
Being this iconic.
Yeah, being this iconic.
Yeah, can confirm.
Her apartment is full of fainting couches.
There's one right at the entrance for when you come in and see all the fainting couches.
Yeah. The only reaction you can have.
Yeah. She's everything I want to be and more. I'm going to give her like...
Oh, the boots.
Yeah.
I'm so glad that this became a Karina does some fashion design episode.
Yeah, let me make this into like... What is this style I'm making? Because it's fur, like big, like old Hollywood fur collar and sleeves, but I wanted to do like a cowboy style.
Like a Western shirt.
Yeah. And then it has like all the tassels.
That's incredible.
I know what this style is called.
Cowvetch.
It's Cowvetch.
Yeah. Cowvetch.
Oh, what am I wearing? Cowvetch sweaty. And then she just keeps walking. Oh, and since she's a cow, it'll have the cowbells.
Yeah.
And she just jingles as she walks.
Jingle jangles down the street.
Yeah.
Again, you can only hear the jingles if you're up close because the sound her thighs make is much louder and bassier.
I need to make her thighs oh so thunderous.
Oh, yeah. Thunder them up.
Yeah, my bad.
Boom.
Boom. She's so hot.
She's so hot right now, Cowvetch.
Yeah.
Now and forever.
I was in Vermont recently and I saw some cows.
But did you see a Cowvetch?
I did not. I just saw some like some real good cows. Like they look just like the cows on the Ben and Jerry's.
Aw. Yeah. Cowvetch isn't a good cow. She's bad. She's a bad bitch.
I was in France recently and I saw some cows.
Whoa.
French Whoa. Cows.
Oh my God, what were they like?
Kind of like this. They were in the field just sort of like stylishly walking around on their hind legs with cigarettes. And
I imagine a French cow would be more stylish than their American counterparts.
Very stylish.
She has piercings.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. Love that.
It upsets the older generation, but gotta admit, it's kind of cool.
If you do something that upsets the older generation, you should follow that impulse. Keep going in that direction. You're headed the right way.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I like Cowvetch. I'm just going to put some embroidery. I'll do that later. It's embroidered up there.
She intimidates me. She makes me feel small and weak by comparison, but I still love her.
Cowvetch is that one Tumblr post that's like, one time I was struggling to open a water bottle and this girl I never spoke to in my class came over and said, "Let me help you, baby." and then struggle to open the water bottle. That's cow vetch.
That's cow vetch.
Let me help you, baby. She refers to everyone as baby.
Yeah, because to her, everyone is a baby.
Yeah. Calvetch is hundreds of years old.
Yeah.
She's immortal.
Calvetch is the only adult.
Yeah, and she's hotter than all of us.
Combined.
Yeah. Okay, I think this is Calvetch.
Yes. Yeah.
I don't even care that this is supposed to be a plant. It's not a plant anymore.
None of us drew plants. None of us came close to drawing plants.
No, but like the plant called Calvetch should change its name now.
Oh, yeah, okay.
I agree.
Because this is...
Yeah.
Because this is Calvetch.
Yeah.
That one's going to be called like purple weed now.
Purple flower weed. Yeah.
Yeah.
Some dumb fucking plant. I don't know. That's a scientific name.
Yeah. Once the scientists see this, that's what it's going to be.
Yeah.
Get a load of this, scientist.
Oh, scientist. I have something you may be interested in.
Look at this. Shows them this drawing.
Check this shit out.
I got your cover of the next Scientific American right here.
How's that for science?
Yeah. Oh.
You want to get the next generation interested in science? Here you go.
Here you go. This is for free. This is all of the drawings we're doing today.
Yep.
Believe it or not. These three drawings are what
Believe
you get.
Believe it or not, yeah. This is the episode.
Open wide, baby. Struggles to put them in your mouth.
I know it seems crazy that these would be the drawings, but it's true.
Listen, we said we were turning plant names into characters. We never said they were going to be human characters.
Or no. Plants, or pleasant.
You get what you get on this show. So enjoy, learn a lesson from it.
Yeah.
You can't always control what you're going to get, okay?
Yeah. I love that song.
You can't always control what you get.
If you feel like you're completely out of control, hit the subscribe button. And if you're still feeling a little untethered after doing that, leave a comment down below describing your ideal meet cute with Calvetch.
Yes, please. And if you want to support more things like this, head over to our Patreon and you can join it for as low as $3 a month, I believe. Or is it two? I forget.
I think it's two.
But it's one
what
of those.
What a steal.
And that's a steal. And that gets you access to the Discord where you can leave us other suggestions to draw.
And if you are just a weird little guy crawling around on the floor digesting fish, watch us on Twitch.
Ooh. Yeah.
We stream on Monday nights, typically. Check it out.
Check it out.
And if you know what cockles is, you owe me money, so go buy some merch.
Thanks for watching, everybody. We're sorry.
I'm sorry to Calvetch only.
Same.
Sorry, Calvetch.